So today's lecture is basically on an important topic in bioinformatics, which is the database searching. Okay, so database searching is can be called as searching for sequences in a database that are similar to a query sequence. That you have a sequence, okay, either it is protein or DNA sequence, and you want to search similar sequences in the database of DNA or protein sequence. And this is sometimes also called as homology searching. Homology searching. The database searching is also called as homology searching because we search the homologous sequences. Okay, we search the sequences based from homology between the two sequences, and this is the most commonly used method in bioinformatics. And it has many applications in bioinformatics and molecular biology. By using the database searching, we can identify functions of the gene or protein. On the basis of database searching, we can retrieve homologous sequences can be retrieved. The genes that you can download, you can identify and download the homologous sequences from the database. Also, based on database searching, you can predict the three-dimensional or 3D structure of the protein or fold of the protein based on the as a result of database searching or the data obtained from database searching. The protein structure can be predicted. Also, as we know that there are sometimes more than one domain in a protein. So, domain characterization, whether this sequence of protein has one domain or two domain or three domain or more domain, can be characterized based on database searching. Database searching also can be used in identifying coding regions, because we know that in the DNA sequence there are coding regions which code for protein, and some are non-coding regions which do not code for protein. So using the database searching, coding regions can be identified. So what is the general principle of database searching? We basically align a query sequence, a sequence which is in hand, which is with us, and we want to analyze that sequence to every sequence in the database. The query sequence is matched with every sequence or aligned with every sequence in the database. And then at the end we select the database sequences with the highest score. On the basis of the alignment, the score is calculated using the scoring matrices, and the highest score sequence are selected. So this is the general principle of database searching. Okay. So there are several algorithms used for database searching. The first is Smith-Waterman algorithm. The second is FASTA, and the third is BLAST or BLAST. Okay. Smith-Waterman program or algorithm for database searching is slow, and the computer program in which it is implemented is called as S-search, and it is available in EDI website. But the FASTA and BLAST, they are the older heuristic. They use older heuristic approach for searching sequences in the database. Likewise, the BLAST is the same based on heuristic methods. Currently, BLAST is acting as a industry standard, and this is the BLAST website. This is the BLAST website. This is the BLAST website. Okay.
जी सर, मैं कह रहा हूँ कि जो आपने क्विज दिया था उसकी स्कोरिंग हो गई है, मतलब ग्रेडिंग कर दी थी आप?
जी जी, ग्रेडिंग कर नहीं आई जी, वो आपको पहुंचा दी जाएगी, वो तो आपको बता देंगे। ओके, so we basically I would repeat again, so how the BLAST results are interpreted. So the first is alignment score, the second is p value, and the third is percentage identity. I will show you example of this at the end of this presentation. So again, alignment score, e value, and percentage identity. Okay, what are the applications of how where the BLAST can be applied? Where BLAST is the BLAST method or database searching is being applied in many applications, in many cases. But I will show you some examples of applications of database searching. Okay, it is not only BLAST, any other program like FASTA and other program can be used for BLAST searching, but BLAST is one of the most widely used programs for database searching in bioinformatics. So the application, and one of the application is predicting functions by using BLAST searching or database searching of we can predict the function of the protein sequence or DNA sequence. If you have a protein sequence and you want to find out the function or predict the function, use protein BLAST, a PsiBLAST program, and a non-redundant database. And a non-redundant database should be used. And if you are using DNA sequence, if you are using DNA or RNA sequence, use BLAST-N or FASTA program and use non-redundant nucleotide database, nucleotide sequence database. Non-redundant database, what is the meaning of non-redundant database? Can anyone tell me what do we understand by non-redundant database? Yes, please. Anyone? Any idea? We have discussed about non-redundant database before. Any idea, please?
रिपीटेड प्रोटीन सीक्वेंसेस नहीं होते हैं, मतलब जो एक बार एंटर हुआ है वो सेकंड दोबारा एंटर नहीं होगा.
यस थैंक यू वेरी मच. दैट इज नॉन रिडंडेंट का मतलब है कि उसमें रिडंडेंसी नहीं होती, यानी कि रिपीटेशन नहीं होती. ओके सो द वन सीक्वेंस अपीयर्स इन द that is one sequence appears in the database once. Okay, so this is okay. Thank you very much. Or if you are using coding sequences, use BLASTX or FASTA program and non-redundant protein database, because coding sequence codes for protein, so it is better whether it is you have DNA or RNA sequence and you know that they are coding for protein. So you can use non-redundant protein databases. Okay. And next is protein structure, application of predicting protein structure. So you have a DNA sequence or protein sequence, but on the basis of this, you can predict about you can have an idea about the 3D structure. Or tertiary structure of that protein, okay, by using database searching. So if you want to do that, use computer program BLASTP or SciBLAST, and the database should be used as PDB, protein data bank database should be used for predicting protein structure about these sequences. And if you have a good homolog, if you found a good homolog on the basis of the searching, that particular structure in the PDB can be used as template to model the QDC. So using that particular structure which is present in PDB, based on that homology, we can construct a model. So this is a separate topic, and we will study this topic under the heading of protein structure prediction. And this modeling is called as homology modeling or comparative protein modeling. We will discuss this in detail later on. Okay. Another application is characterization of the domains, characterizing domains. So if you have a sequence and you find out how many different domains are there, and what are the length of the domain, and so on. So use program BLASTP and or SciBLAST and a domain database. So there are some databases in which domain that is information is there. For example, Proteome is a database containing the protein sequence, protein domain. You can also use BLASTP or SciBLAST or a non-redundant protein database can also be used in order to find out, in order to characterize domain. It is better if you know that your sequence has that is more than one domain, or if you have some idea about it, you can also segment the QD sequence, that is divide the Turing sequence into different segments and then perform your analysis. Usually this is completed by pattern or motif structures. So pattern and motif structures should also be performed in addition to the BLAST searching for characterization of the domains. Okay, next. Another is interesting, again, by using database searching, we can detect genomes. We can detect, genes in our sequence. If you want to detect genes in your sequence, use BLASTX or FASTX programs. Either one of them, either FASTX or BLASTX, and the database you have to select is non-redundant protein database. You can also use BLASTN and T-BLASTX program and the EST database for and a well-characterized mRNA database can also be used, like RepSeq database, used in order to find out, in order to detect genes in the input accuracy. Okay, so there are some tips about database searching. First of all, use latest version of the database. So databases are continuously being updated and new sequences are being added in the databases. So it is better to use latest version of database. And you should use non-redundant database preferably. This is the first tip for database searching. And the second is, for sensitive searches, use more than one program. I have mentioned several programs, last version, so it is better if you want to use more than one. The third tip is, you should translate DNA QA sequence to search a protein database. It is better to translate the DNA to protein and then do the protein searching. The fourth tip is, when using a protein query sequence, also search 6-frame translation of a DNA database, because a DNA can be translated in 6 frames. So also you should search 6-frame translation. Split large query sequence into a smaller segments, that is say about, in case of DNA, 1,000 sequences, and in case of protein, 200 amino acid sequences can be used for analysis. There is another important and interesting tip, and this is, if a sequence found to contain a segment with a lot of hits in the database, delete that segment and repeat the search. Sometimes a segment of 100 or 200 or so nucleotides, for example, nucleotide sequence is matching with many sequences in the database. So it is better to delete that particular segment from that sequence and then repeat the search. It will give you the results about the more clear results will be found. Okay, so this is the, now after discussion about different aspects of BLAST searching or database searching, now we are at the page of the BLAST searching page of BLAST server in NCBI website. Okay, and you see that there are several different type of BLAST version is written over here. Nucleotide BLAST. Okay. Protein BLAST for protein sequences. BLAST X for DNA sequences. T BLAST N for, again, DNA sequences. And T BLAST X for sequences. So these are different programs used for BLAST searching. So, then you will click any of these, you will come to another page, this type of page, and what you do, you have to paste or copy, sorry, paste your sequence over here in this window. You have to paste your sequence over here, or you can upload your sequence if your sequence is in a file, in a text file, you can upload your sequence over here. So first thing you do this, and the second is that you have to select the database against which your sequence needs to be analyzed, need to be searched or aligned. Why? This window, you can select the database. Over here, you can select the database. So two things mainly, at least two things you have to do for blasting. First, you have to paste or you have to upload your sequence, and the second, you have to select the database. Okay? And then, when you will submit the submit button is the blast page. You will have something this type of page. Okay. And this is the header of the page, and it is telling us that the sequence was nucleotide sequence or DNA sequence, and the sequence containing 244 letters. Okay. And the database was used was HTGS, this is high throughput genome sequencer, and the computer program used was BLASTn. The computer program used was BLASTn, and this is basically the diagrammatic result showing to you. This is your theory sequence. This is the theory sequence starting from 1 to 244. And these are the matches with which your theory sequence is matching, either entirely matching or partial matching. It depends on the match. Okay. And this is the color that, sorry. And this is the
showing the
जी बताइए क्या कह रहे हैं sorry
जो alignment cone है
जी
ये alignment वो है letters है
अभी alignment score नहीं दिखाया है अभी मैं alignment score दिखाया नहीं है अभी अगले slide में alignment score देखेंगे okay ठीक है So this is basically, this is showing that it is, the red color is showing the alignment score of this sequence with the theory sequence is more than 200. And this color, this pink color is showing, this is my pink color, is showing that the alignment score of this sequence with the theory sequence is between 80 to 200. Okay? So when you will go down in the same page, you will find this thing. You will find this thing. This is showing the alignment score. Okay? That the sequence you have submitted is matching. The top match is this sequence, and the alignment score is 363. And this sequence is 100% matching with your sequence, and the E value is very low, that is 3 × 10⁻⁷, very low, means that is very high matching, of course, because it is 100% coverage, and the sequence identity between these two sequences is 93%. So this is one parameter. This is another parameter, and this is the third parameter which we have discussed, I have discussed in the previous slide in this lecture, which is normally we consider during interpretation of the BLAST results. Okay. And then after that, below the below this table, you will find this the alignment between the Turing sequence and the sequence with which it is matched. It is aligned. So this you see that this is the first alignment. It is aligned. Our sequence was aligned with some sequence called Lotus japonicus. This is name of the plant. And this is our Curie sequence, and this is this subject sequence. This is number of the Curie sequence is starting from 1 to 60 in one first line, and the second has 61 to 120, and at the end 244. So this is the alignment. So when there is a matching, a line is drawn, and then there is no matching or gap. You see that there is a gap over here. So this is, again, this is a gap. And this is a gap, no alignment. And this is again a gap. But this is, you see that this is a mismatch. The A is not, is aligned with G, but it is a mismatch. Okay, so there is a mismatch also, and you can see insertion deletion in this sequence, in this alignment and matching also. When there is a match, a line is mentioned by a match in this. So this is how the sequence alignment is shown as a result of last search. Okay, and this is the first alignment. And this, which is the topmost, and this is the second top alignment, and after that the third top, and fourth, and fifth, and so on. So this is how the blast search is result is mentioned as a result of blast search in the blast database. So.